Hello everyone, my name is Kruthi Srinivasa. I am the product manager for Fortify on-demand SaaS product. I'm excited to share with you the new capability of webhooks, which is available in our 21.2 FOD release. Many of you techies might already be familiar with what webhooks are. For those that are not, here is a non-technical illustration. Imagine you are at a restaurant waiting for a table, or you are a banking customer waiting for your account to be managed with a service agent or a phone call. In either of those situations, the typical method is to get the status by periodically checking with the server, also called polling technique. Wouldn't it be nice to free you up if you are notified automatically when status changes? In the case of restaurant, beeping services are available, and in the case of banking, callback services are available. Exactly the same situation, exactly the same concept is applicable in the AppSec context as well in the cloud paradigm. Typically, depending on the size of the scan, it might take up to several hours to process a single scan. Instead of constantly polling for updates, you can subscribe to the status change events by providing an endpoint as a callback function. This allows your system to initiate workflows to process the results further automatically. A few example use cases for FOD webhook invocation could be like creating defects in the defect tracking system like Jira or ServiceNow. Once the webhook notification is delivered. Our implementation of webhooks in this release focuses on scan status updates, but it can be applied to other events like data exports, reports, or even administrative events in future releases. Now let's look at the demonstration. I'm logged into FOD portal, as you can see here, and I'm on applications page. You can navigate to webhooks function, which is located under administration section. So let's go there. You can see the webhook icon at the left hand side, bottom of the page. Let's click that. Once you're on this page, you can see the list of webhooks that are currently configured for this tenant. There are some actions like edit, assign, release, and delete on this page. As you can see here for this particular webhook, the assign release is grayed out, which means that this webhook is configured to monitor all release scan events. So now let's click on the add webhook button. Now we are on add or edit webhook screen. Here, this is a required listener payload URL. So I have a locally configured listener. So let me configure that listener for the webhook. And you can always add description to your webhook. And you can specify a secret value that should be sent as a digital signature to your webhook endpoint if your listener mandates. Also, this is where you would turn on this to monitor all application releases for this particular webhook. If you don't want to do that and assign specific releases, I will show you how to do that. You can always keep this webhook active or inactivated for a short for a time being if you don't want FOD notifications to be delivered. Now we on the right hand side of the screen, you see the events that this webhook is triggered. They're all scan events like started, resumed, completed, paused, and canceled. Let's go ahead and turn on a few of these events for demo purposes. And there is a test webhook button here that you can click and make sure that a webhook FOD is able to reach that listener. Let's click that. All right, we were able to successfully ping the listener. So now let's go ahead and save it. As you can see here, there is an alert box that pops up saying that there are no assigned releases to this webhook, which means that we disabled monitoring all releases. So now it's required for us to assign at least one release that is monitored by this webhook. So let's go ahead and do that. This is our webhook that we just configured. As you can see, the assigned release is enabled since we did not select monitor all releases on the edit screen or add screen. So let's click on that. Now you will see all the list of applications here, applications and releases. So let's go ahead and pick a particular application and release for this demo purposes and save it. Now, if you want to go back to the edit, if you want to go back to the assigned release, you will now see here that I have chosen this particular release for chosen this release so that a webhook can monitor the scan events for this release. So let's cancel. Now let's go back to your applications page and select the application and the release where webhook is monitoring. Webhook we just configured is monitoring this application release. So let's kick off a scan so that we can see the webhook delivery in action. While we are waiting for this page, I can show you here that the ping that was delivered is received by the listener and it will show up this way. It has a delivery ID and a webhook ID. So, all right, now we are on the release page and let's go ahead and configure a static scan. Since we configured the webhook to monitor scan start event. All right, so let me kick off a scan for this release. All right, so now we have a scan that has been queued up for this release. So let's give it a minute for it to be changing to the start scan status. All right, we got the scan to start now. And as you can see on my listener side, I just got a webhook notified saying scan started with a scan ID, tenant ID, application name, release ID, release name, and the scan type. And also it has a webhook ID too. So this is the payload that was delivered to my listener by the webhook, FOD webhook. And that's all I have today. You can definitely go to the administration and webhooks and also take a look at the webhook deliveries page to see that there was a webhook that was delivered. And you can always click on the details and view the request and the response for this delivery. That's all I got. Thank you so much for watching my video. Have a good day.